Welcome back. We are learning Tanya, chapter 44, Likutei Amorim. We're going to speak about the two categories of love. Today's lesson, when the love of God is still in the latent or developmental stages, in mind or depth of heart, it has not emerged as an actual emotion, it reaches the realm of Yetzirah formation. Whereas once one achieves a real conscious feeling of love or fear, this reaches the realm of Berea, creation, which is predominantly intellectual. The world of formation is predominantly emotional. The world of Berea is predominantly intellectual. Since this is the only way one can achieve this result, through conscious meditative thought, to ascend from the world of Bria to from the world of Yetzirah to the world of Bria, from formation to creation. The said two categories of love, that of my soul, one is called that of my soul, the love a Jew feels for God upon realizing that He is His true life, and that which is like a son loving God as one's true father. One is love because you're understanding, you know, the benefits, you know, what you're getting, you know, why it makes sense for you to love God. The other one is like a son loves his father. I don't know much. I know he's my father. I love him. That's it. So it's two bechinas, two levels, two categories of love. Av shen Yerushalem aviseinu, although it's inheritance to us from our forefathers. V'chein ayiro aklulo b'en, and also the yira, we said fear, also comes together with love. Your love might be more dominating, but it has always fear in it. Shiliro, what's the fear? Poet chas v'shalom, not fear of punishment, you are fearing to separate from Hashem. Liporid chas v'sholem, mimokor chayenu, from the source of our life, ve'avino amiti, and our true father, Baruch Hu. When one feels that God is his true, is the true source of his life, when you feel that way, he will fear to transgress so as not to become separated from his source of life. So his main worry, and that he doesn't want to sin, is because he doesn't want to be separated from Hashem. It's like someone does not want to disappoint his father. Someone does not want to sever his relationship with his father. It's a whole different category. So guy is afraid to be punished. Guy is afraid to sever the relationship. It's a different story. Welcome, Mr. Cohen. Okay. So the feeling of God being one's true father will likewise keep him from sinning, since he does not want to be torn away from his father. Although both the above mentioned degrees of love and fear are instinctively found within Jews, they don't have to do something special, it's there. Nevertheless, they are called b'shem dechilu rechimutim. They are called natural love and fear, or fear and love. Aval shem machshav to levav tomus libo. But when they are to be found in the mind and in his thought only, v'talumus libo, and in his recesses of his heart, v'az over here, see, right in the latency of the heart. Then they only ascend all the way to the world of formation, which is the world of emotions. And there you can elevate to the world of formation, you can elevate all the Torah mitzvahs that you did, because they were generated because of these emotions. So you take them to the world of emotions. These levels of love are the cause of the performance of one's Torah and mitzvahs, for they result from the portrayal of this love in his mind. But when they, the 2 degrees of love, are in a manifest state in the heart as a result of his contemplation, they are called in the Zohar, Rusa Deliba. What does it mean, Rusa Deliba? The heart's desire. A more exalted love than the natural love. And now they are ascending to where? To the 10 spheres of creation. And they are elevating the Torah and the mitzvahs that you did to the world of creation, because they were generated through the intellect. If they're generated through intellect, contemplation, meditation, mindfulness, it goes to the world of Bria, which is intellectual world. The reason this is indeed so, notwithstanding the fact that they are naturally found with the soul of every Jew, is now given. Them coming out from their concealment of the heart to be revealed. How does it come out? Through das, through knowledge. What is skiasamachshove? Powerful fixation of the mind and an intense concentration. Meaning it's not easy, not simple. Powerfully and frequently concentrating the depth of his heart on the blessed Ein Sof, the infinite light of Hashem, Echu Chayeinu Mamish, contemplating that he is our very life and our blessed true Father, Avinu Amiti Bochu, Umudazo Meshikosu Tikunim, it's known what it's written, which is written Tikun Zayar, what is written Tikunim, Kibe'il Ma'abriyo Mekano Tamanim Oilo. Comes to the world of Bria, what do we have there? Who is nesting there? Supernal Mother, the level of Bina of Atzilus is found in the world of Bria. Understanding within the world, understanding of Atzilus is nesting in Bria. The level of Bina of Atzilus, which is in terms of man's spiritual service, is contemplation of the infinite light of the blessed Ein Sof, the giver of life, blessed be he. And this is in accordance with the teaching of Elijah, Tikkun Ezeel. Because we say, what is in Tikkun Ezeel? Posach Elio. Elio opened up. Elio was the one that started speaking. In the section beginning, Potach Elio, Bina is the heart. And with it, the heart understand. This means to say that the meditation and understanding taking place in the mind illuminate the heart. Bino Livo, you have meditation and understanding. It happens in the mind, it will affect, illuminate the heart. So since the contemplation of godliness is related to the world of Bria, the world which is illuminated by Bina of Atzilus, it follows that the various forms of love which are revealed through such contemplation have their place in the world as well. And it is there that they elevate one's Torah mitzvahs. Since these two kinds of love possesses all these qualities, it would seem that they should suffice. And love born wholly of intellect is superfluous. Furthermore, these two categories of love that have been referred to above, the love of my soul and the love of like son, incorporate a quality of love which is greater and more sublime than intelligent fear and love. The kind that results from contemplating God's greatness, the love termed above, avas elom, worldly love, these two kinds of love also partake of the quality of avo abo, which is the great love, which is loftier than avas elom. Avo abo is loftier than avas elom. Great love is loftier than the worldly love. So the takeaway from today's Tanya: you love life and you love your father. You fear separating from your life or your father. You don't want to separate from your life and you don't want to separate from your father. Make this feeling real about God, who is your life and your father. Contemplate and delve deeply on how God is your life and is your father. The love and fear will follow. Bruchim Tiyu. I will have shortly another video on the daily Parsha and then Yaakov.